pag-usapan natin yung step-by-step na mga procedures para mag-register kayo sa MySOS application. Kasi isa ito sa mga importante na application na kailangan nyong i-present dito sa Japan Immigration. Galing to mismo sa website ng Ministry Health, Labor, and Welfare. So sa mga pinakita ko previously, yun yung mga screen grab na ginawa nung aking misis during nung kanyang pagre-register sa application. Hi guys, this is Alan. Welcome back to this channel, Gaijin World. So ito yung website na kung saan i-guide tayo. Galing ito sa Ministry of Health, Labor, and Welfare. So ito yung guide para mag-pre-register for quarantine procedures. So sabi dito, an application can be used for some quarantine procedures before you enter Japan. Pre-registration for quarantine procedures, an application can be used for some quarantine procedures before you enter Japan. So ito yung mga requirements para kayo ay papasukin. Pag kayo ay nasa immigration na dito sa Japan, ito yung mga dapat ninyong ipakita or i-present. Number 1, yung questionnaire via web. Number 2, yung written pledge. Number 3, yung vaccination certificate. Kung hindi nyo pa napanood yung previous video ko about sa mga vaccination, yung mga types ng vaccination certificate na dapat nyo i-present, ay i-check nyo yung video na yon. And number 4, yung test certificate na dapat nakuha ninyo before less than 72 hours before departure. Tapos meron dito, have image data ready. Fast track cannot be used if registration not complete by 16 hours before arrival. So yung fast track kasi ay para ito sa mga malapit ng bumiyahe papunta dito sa Japan. So gagawin nyo lang yan prior 16 hours before your arrival sa Japan. Then according sa fast track website, ito ay available sa mga papasok from Narita International Airport, Haneda Airport, Chubu Center International Airport kung saan galing yung aking mag-ina, Kansai International Airport, and Fukuoka Airport. Quarantine procedures upon arrival at the airport could still take some time due to congestion situation even if you have registered via fast track. Your understanding is appreciated. So isa nga sa mga requirements na dapat mong sundin ay yung mag-download ka ng MySOS app. So ito yung kanyang QR code. So according dito, app installation, account registration. Please follow instruction in the manual to install the health and location monitoring app, yung MySOS, and complete account registration. If you have already installed MySOS, please scan the dedicated QR code again or tap the dedicated URL. If the version of the app is old, you may need to update it. Importante na updated yung inyong tablet or yung iPhone na gagamitin nyo sa pag-present nitong MySOS application. So ito na yung unang makikita ninyo once na na-download nyo yung MySOS. Confirmation of companion, using fast track with an accompanying person. Kung halimbawa katulad nung sa situation namin, yung wife ko at kasama niya yung aming anak. So yun yung accompanying person niya. So pwede na kayong gumamit ng iisang application kung minor naman yung kasama ninyo. 12 years old and below. So kung 13 years old and above, ay magkakaroon na siya ng separate application or separate phone na naka-install yung MySOS application. Using fast track with an accompanying person, if someone is entering Japan with you, see instruction in the manual below to register the person. You can use fast track together. Note, you can also register accompanying person later. Once registered, no person can be deleted. If a registered person is unable to enter Japan together, you must uninstall the application and then reinstall it starting with step 1. So, step 1.3, screen for confirming intention to use the fast track. So, ito yung magiging makikita nyo sa screen. After account registration, you will see a confirmation screen about using fast track. If you intend to use fast track, click yes. The top screen of fast track user mode will open. If you click no on the screen, you will not be able to use fast track. If you accidentally click no here, please uninstall the application and then reinstall it starting with step 1. So, ito naman, step 1.4, fast track top screen. The fast track screen will open. So, once na nag-yes na kayo, ganito na yung screen na makikita ninyo. Merong pre-registration for quarantine procedures and may pre-registration instruction. If you tap the pre-registration for quarantine procedures, number 1 button, a screen will open for each step of the process. So, ito yung number 1. So, dito kayo mag-start. Pre-registration for quarantine procedures. If you tap pre-registration instructions, number 2, a manual will open to explain this feature. So, dun tayo sa number 1. Then, sa number 1.5, screen for pre-registration for quarantine procedures, name, passport number, and date of birth as entered for MySOS account registration will be displayed. So, ganito yung magiging screen ninyo So, current status is not yet registered. Ilalagay nyo pa lang yung inyong pangalan, yung passport, and yung date of birth. Register the four items shown at least 16 hours before scheduled flight arrival time in Japan. If an accompanying person is registered, you need to handle each of the four items for yourself and each person. So, medyo matrabaho kung meron kayong mga minor na makakasama sa inyo and lahat yun ay kailangan nyong i-register isa-isa dito sa isang application. When entering your responses, tap the person registering menu to and select the person. Then sa susunod na screen, ganito yung makikita ninyo. So pwede na kayo mag-select ng tao or ni-register ninyong accompanying person. 1.6 step, selecting accompanying person. If there is an accompanying person, select which person's information you wish to view at any time with the person's registering pull-down menu. Tap the person's registering menu to see the names of persons registered and select one. That person's name and information will be displayed. If there is an accompanying person, the registration must be done for yourself and each accompanying person. So medyo matrabaho talaga siya. Next screen, ito ay step 2 na. So makikita nyo na dito yung pre-registration for quarantine procedure na screen. So nandito na yung number 2, questionnaire web. So kailangan nyo na mag-register dito. Questionnaire web, open please. Open pre-registration for quarantine procedure screen. Be sure your name is displayed in the person registering pull-down menu. Number 1 and tap questionnaire web number 2. So number 1, pipiliin nyo yung person na ni-register nyo dito. Select nyo yun yung, let's say, accompanying person. Then, step 2 nun, pagkapili nyo nung registered person, ay pupunta na kayo dito sa questionnaire web. If an accompanying person is registered, each person needs to answer questionnaire web. When answering, be sure the correct person's name is displayed in the person registering menu number 1, then tap questionnaire web number 2. Then, step 2.2, ganito na yung magiging screen. So, makikita ninyo, pwede kayong mamili ng language dyan. So, syempre, select nyo English. Matatranslate na automatically yung page. So, questionnaire web, enter information. The questionnaire screen will open. Please read, tap next, and then enter your response on each screen. Note that input errors are displayed in red. So, kapag nagkamali kayo, ay ma-highlight yun in red. Information on persons entering Japan, 1 of 1 to 1.7. Information on accommodation in Japan ay nasa 2-1 to 2-2. Yung information naman na kailangan yung i-input on recent travel to areas with outbreaks. Kung kayo ay bumiyahe dun sa mga designated countries na merong Omicron na hotspot. Then, information on health condition nasa 4.1 to 4.7. And follow-up information naman ay nasa 5.1 to 5.3. So, gagawa tayo ng separate video dito. Kaya abangan niyo yung mga susunod ko pang video na i-upload. Then, dun sa questionnaire step 2.3, questionnaire web confirm, ito na yung magiging screenshot or ito na yung magiging screen ninyo once na kayo nag-proceed sa mga susunod na pages. So, yung na-discuss ko kanina, yun na yun, yung mga information na kailangan yung input. Then, on the final confirm responses screen, confirm that the content is correct. If your responses are all correct, tap complete response. To make corrections, tap back. After you tap complete response, you will return to the fast track screen. So, yung step 2.4 ay naka-register na kayo. So, magkakaroon na kayo ng QR code. So, makikita nyo na dito yung QR code. Then, yung inyong questionnaire web dito ay naka-register na. Then, nakalagay dito registration procedure time remaining to complete registration is 38 hours and 29 minutes. So, meron siyang time limit. Questionnaire web display screen, when responses are complete, the respondent's QR code is generated. Number 1, and questionnaire web status number 2 will show as registered. Time remaining number 3 will be shown. Please complete all registration procedures within the time. After accompanying person responses are complete, a QR code will be generated and displayed. Note, select each person's information with the person's registering number 4. So sa step 2.4, questionnaire web display screen, makikita nyo nga ninyo dyan yung mga na-register ninyong pangalan ng mga accompanying person and registered na rin yung inyong questionnaire web. Then magkakaroon na rin kayo ng QR code at nakikita nyo na din yung time remaining para makomplete nyo yung registration. So when responses are complete, the respondent's QR code is generated, number 1, and questionnaire web status number 2 will show as registered. Time remaining, number 3, will be shown, please complete all registration procedures within the time. After combining person responses are complete, a QR code will be generated and displayed. Note, select each person's information with the person's registering menu. So, kailangan ninyong gawin ito kung ilang tao yung magiging accompanying person ninyo sa pagpasok dito sa Japan. Yun din yung ilang beses ninyong gagawin itong kailangan nyo silang i-register isa-isa. So, ayan guys, I hope nagustuhan nyo itong video na to. Kung nagustuhan nyo, please like this video and mag-comment na rin kayo. I-share nyo na rin to sa mga papasok pa lang dito sa Japan at nire-ready na yung kanilang mga documents, yung kanilang mga applications para maipakita ito, ma-present yan dito sa Japan Immigration. So, maraming salamat sa panonood at sa mga hindi pa nakapag-subscribe, mag-subscribe na kayo and hit nyo yung notification bell para lagi kayong updated sa mga ganitong klaseng videos na magre-ready sa inyo papunta dito sa Japan. Ito yung mga importanteng mga bagay na kailangan ninyong gawin para hindi kayo ma-hassle pagdating dito or hindi kayo magkaroon ng problema. Ayan. So, huwag nyo rin kalimutang i-check yung aming playlist dahil marami kaming playlist dyan na makakatulong sa inyong pamumuhay pagdating ninyo dito sa Japan. Thank you so much again for watching and I will see you on our next video. Abangan ninyo yung mga susunod ko pang i-upload na video, yung kasunod na part nito dahil sobrang haba ng video na to at kailangan nating putulin. So, ito pa lang yung unang part ng video na to about my SOS application. Again, thank you so much at huwag nyo kalimutang check yung mga videos na lalabas dito sa screen.